the chaplet of the seven sorrows of the Blessed Virgin Mary, the prophecy of Simeon, I grieve for thee, O Mary, most sorrowful, in the affliction of thy tender heart, at the prophecy of the holy and aged Simeon, dear mother, by thy heart so afflicted, obtain for me the virtue of humility and the gift of the holy fear of God. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Our Mother, most sorrowful, the second sorrow, the flight into Egypt, I grieve for thee, O Mary, most sorrowful, in the anguish of thy most affectionate heart during the flight into Egypt and thy sojourn there. Dear Mother, by thy heart so troubled, obtain for me the virtue of generosity, especially towards the poor, and the gift of piety. Ave Maria, gratia plena, Dominus tecum, benedicta tu in mulieribus, et benedictus fructus ventris tui, Iesus.
Santa Maria, Mater Dei, ora pro nobis peccatoribus, nunc et in hora mortis nostrae. Amen.
Ave Maria, gratia plena, Dominus tecum, benedicta tu in mulieribus, et benedictus fructus ventris tui, Iesus.
Santa Maria, Mater Dei, ora pro nobis peccatoribus, nunc et in hora mortis nostrae. Amen.
Ave Maria, gratia plena Dominus tecum, benedicta tu in mulieribus, et benedictus fructus ventris tui, Iesus.
Santa Maria, Mater Dei, ora pro nobis peccatoribus, nunc et in hora mortis nostrae.
Amen. Ave Maria, gratia plena Dominus tecum, benedicta tu in mulieribus, et benedictus fructus ventris tui, Iesus.
Santa Maria, Mater Dei, ora pro nobis peccatoribus, nunc et in hora mortis nostrae. Amen.
Ave Maria, gratia plena Dominus tecum, benedicta tu in mulieribus, et benedictus fructus ventris tui, Iesus.
Santa Maria, Mater Dei, ora pro nobis peccatoribus, nunc et in hora mortis nostrae. Amen.
Ave Maria, gratia plena Dominus tecum, benedicta tu in mulieribus, et benedictus fructus ventris tui, Iesus.
Santa Maria, Mater Dei, ora pro nobis peccatoribus, nunc et in hora mortis nostrae. Amen.
Ave Maria, gratia plena Dominus tecum, benedicta tu in mulieribus, et benedictus fructus ventris tui, Iesus.
Santa Maria, Mater Dei, ora pro nobis peccatoribus, nunc et in hora mortis nostrae. Amen.
Our Mother, most sorrowful,
pray for us.
The third sorrow, the loss of the child Jesus. I grieve for thee, O Mary, most sorrowful, in those anxieties which try thy troubled heart at the loss of thy dear Jesus. Dear Mother, by thy heart so full of anguish, obtain for me the virtue of chastity and the gift of knowledge. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Our Mother, most sorrowful,
pray for us.
The fourth sorrow, the meeting with Jesus on the way to Calvary. I grieve for thee, O Mary, most sorrowful, in the consternation of thy heart at meeting Jesus as he carried his cross. Dear Mother, by thy heart, so troubled, obtain for me the virtue of patience and the gift of fortitude. Ave Maria, gratia plena Dominus tecum, benedicta tu in mulieribus, et benedictus fructus ventris tui, Jesus.
Santa Maria, Mater Dei, ora pro nobis peccatoribus, nunc et in hora mortis nostrae.
Ave Maria, gratia plena Dominus tecum, benedicta tu in mulieribus, et benedictus fructus ventris tui, Jesus.
Santa Maria, Mater Dei, ora pro nobis peccatoribus, nunc et in hora mortis nostrae.
Ave Maria, gratia plena Dominus tecum, benedicta tu in mulieribus, et benedictus fructus ventris tui, Jesus.
Santa Maria, Mater Dei, ora pro nobis peccatoribus, nunc et in hora mortis nostrae.
Ave Maria, gratia plena Dominus tecum, benedicta tu in mulieribus, et benedictus fructus ventris tui, Jesus.
Santa Maria, Mater Dei, ora pro nobis peccatoribus, nunc et in hora mortis nostrae.
Ave Maria, gratia plena Dominus tecum, benedicta tu in mulieribus, et benedictus fructus ventris tui, Jesus.
Santa Maria, Mater Dei, ora pro nobis peccatoribus, nunc et in hora mortis nostrae.
Ave Maria, gratia plena Dominus tecum, benedicta tu in mulieribus, et benedictus fructus ventris tui, Jesus.
Santa Maria, Mater Dei, ora pro nobis peccatoribus, nunc et in hora mortis nostrae.
Ave Maria, gratia plena Dominus tecum, benedicta tu in mulieribus, et benedictus fructus ventris tui, Jesus.
Santa Maria, Mater Dei, ora pro nobis peccatoribus, nunc et in hora mortis nostrae.
Our Mother, most sorrowful, the fifth sorrow, Mary stands at the foot of the cross, watching her son die. I grieve for thee, O Mary, most sorrowful, in the martyrdom which thy generous heart endured, in standing near Jesus in his agony. Dear Mother, by thy heart afflicted in such wise, obtain for me the virtue of temperance and the gift of counsel. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Our Mother, most sorrowful,
pray for us.
The sixth sorrow. The body of Jesus is taken down from the cross and laid in the arms of his mother. I grieve for thee, O Mary, most sorrowful, in the woundings of thy compassionate heart, when the side of Jesus was struck by the lance and his heart was pierced. Dear Mother, by thy heart thus transfixed, obtain for me the virtue of fraternal charity and the gift of understanding. Ave Maria, gratia plena, Dominus tecum, benedicta tu in mulieribus, et benedictus fructus ventris tui, Iesus.
Santa Maria, Mater Dei, ora pro nobis peccatoribus, nunc et in hora mortis nostrae.
Amen. Ave Maria, gratia plena, Dominus tecum, benedicta tu in mulieribus, et benedictus fructus ventris tui, Iesus.
Santa Maria, Mater Dei, ora pro nobis peccatoribus, nunc et in hora mortis nostrae.
Ave Maria, gratia plena, Dominus tecum, benedicta tu in mulieribus, et benedictus fructus ventris tui, Iesus.
Santa Maria, Mater Dei, ora pro nobis peccatoribus, nunc et in hora mortis nostrae.
Ave Maria, gratia plena, Dominus tecum, benedicta tu in mulieribus, et benedictus fructus ventris tui, Iesus.
Santa Maria, Mater Dei, ora pro nobis peccatoribus, nunc et in hora mortis nostrae.
Ave Maria, gratia plena, Dominus tecum, benedicta tu in mulieribus, et benedictus fructus ventris tui, Iesus.
Santa Maria, Mater Dei, ora pro nobis peccatoribus, nunc et in hora mortis nostrae.
Ave Maria, gratia plena, Dominus tecum, benedicta tu in mulieribus, et benedictus fructus ventris tui, Iesus.
Santa Maria, Mater Dei, ora pro nobis peccatoribus, nunc et in hora mortis nostrae.
Ave Maria, gratia plena, Dominus tecum, benedicta tu in mulieribus, et benedictus fructus ventris tui, Iesus.
Santa Maria, Mater Dei, ora pro nobis peccatoribus, nunc et in hora mortis nostrae. Amen.
Our Mother, most sorrowful,
pray for us.
The seventh sorrow, the my Lord is placed in the tomb. I grieve for thee, O Mary, most sorrowful, for the pangs that wrenched thy most loving heart at the burial of Jesus. Dear Mother, by thy heart, sunk in the bitterness of desolation, obtain for me the virtue of diligence and the gift of wisdom. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death.
Full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death.
Our Mother, most sorrowful,
pray for us.
Three Hail Marys, in honor of the tears which Mary shed at the passion of her divine Son. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Pray for us, O Virgin most sorrowful, that we may be made worthy of the promises of Christ. Let us pray. Let intercession be made for us, we beseech thee, O Lord Jesus Christ, now and at the hour of our death, before the throne of thy mercy, by the Blessed Virgin Mary, thy mother, whose most holy soul was pierced by a sword of sorrow in the hour of thy bitter passion. Through thee, Jesus Christ, Savior of the world, who with the Father and the Holy Ghost livest and reignest, world without end.
Amen.
Our Mother of Sorrows, pray for us. Saint Gabriel of Our Lady of Sorrows,
pray for us.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost. Amen. My dear parishioners, I led the chapter of Our Lady of Sorrows a little differently. There are a lot of different versions or ways. Basically, it consists of seven sets of seven Hail Marys in honor of her seven sorrows, and concluding with three Hail Marys in honor of the tears that she shed. I used Recolta number 383 for the prayers. There are many different ones. Some versions will say to say in Our Father before each seven Hail Marys, but that's optional. Devotion to Our Mother of Sorrows is very much a part of our Catholic life. Now the last stained glass window on the left side of the church, which you can't really see now because it's dark outside, is Saint Gabriel of Our Lady of Sorrows. And when we had these windows made, I was trying to come up with saints that I thought would have a special meaning for minor seminarians and major seminarians for that matter. And he certainly is one. He sanctified himself by living the common life, was not known for doing any extraordinary heroic actions during his life, but his entire life was heroic. But he sanctified himself in addition to his efforts in living his vocation, he sanctified himself through his devotion to Our Lady of Sorrows. And in that regard, I want to read to you the collect. It's an English translation of the collect that we read at Mass this morning for his feast day. And it says, O God, you taught Blessed Gabriel diligently to ponder the sorrows of your most sweet mother, and exalted him to the glory of sanctity and the working of miracles. Grant us, through his intercession and example, so to mourn with your mother, that we may be saved through her maternal care. Lord, Lord Jesus Christ, etc. That one has the you and more, but you get the idea that he sanctified himself through that particular devotion. Now, there are, and I've read this in a number of books, four promises for those who have devotion to Our Lady of Sorrows. And I will read them to you from this little booklet. I've seen another set of supposedly seven promises attributed to St. Bridget, but I'm skeptical of that because I haven't seen it in very many places. But these four I've seen frequently in books with an imprimatur. I don't know who they were given to, but I'm just reading them to you. So four promises for those who have a devotion to Our Lady's sorrows. Number one, those who invoke the Heavenly Mother through her sorrows will merit to obtain the repentance of all their sins before death. Number two, our Lord will protect them in their tribulations, especially in the hour of death. Number three, he will impress upon them the memory of his passion and will reward them for it in heaven. And number four, he will commit such devout servants into the hands of Mary that she may obtain for them all the graces she desires. Now that's very believable. Those are very similar to the promises given by our Blessed Mother for those who are devoted to her rosary. But beautiful promises that show us the appreciation Our Lady has for us compassionating her in her sorrows. Now you think about it. What son or daughter, what child would not be moved at the tears of his mother, having caused his mother to be sad, to be moved to tears? What child would be so hardened as not to feel ashamed and regretful, etc.? Especially as we think about the passion of her divine son. Now in this regard, I want to read to you a little bit about the title of Our Lady that is used in Catholic theology and devotion. Because God is harmonious and orderly in all of his works. And our fall was brought about by the cooperation of a man and a woman. True, theologians tell us that if Eve alone had eaten the forbidden fruit, and when she offered it to Adam, he refused, we would not be in a fallen state. It is the sin of Adam as the head of the human race that has caused our own misery to have original sin. But Eve, of course, was very much a part of that, having been the first to eat the forbidden fruit, offering it to Adam. So our downfall was brought about by the cooperation of a man and a woman. And thus it is only fitting that our redemption should come about by the cooperation of a man, Jesus Christ, and a woman. Of course, our Blessed Mother. It's only fitting. So the fathers call Our Lady the new Eve, just as they call Christ the new Adam, or a second Adam. Read you a little bit from the popes. This is Pope St. Pius X in 1904. Now, from this common sharing of will and suffering between Christ and Mary, She merited to become most worthily the reparatrix of the lost world, and therefore dispensatrix of all the gifts which Jesus gained for us. Since she was associated by Christ with himself in the work of human redemption, she merited for us congruously, as they say, what Christ merited condignly. So there's two theological terms, and the gist of it is that Our Lady's sorrows were not essential to the redemption, because of course Jesus Christ, who is God, is infinite, and everything he did had an infinite value. He did not need Our Lady's sorrows joined to his passion to bring about our redemption. It wasn't necessary, but it was fitting that she should suffer along with him. And here's Pope Benedict XV. With her suffering and dying son, Mary endured suffering and almost death. She gave up her mother's rights over her son to procure the salvation of mankind and to appease the divine justice. She, as much as she could, immolated her son so that one can truly affirm that together with Christ, she has redeemed the human race. So again, that's what we mean by the title, co-redemptrix. Now you know that there are two feast days to honor the seven sorrows of Our Lady. The one in Lent, which is on the Friday of Passion Week, which I think this year is maybe the 23rd or 24th, thereabouts, 22nd of March. It's movable, always on the Friday of Passion Week. More emphasizes her sorrows during the Passion. And then the one on September 15th is to honor all seven sorrows of Our Lady. And of course, September is the month of the seven sorrows of Our Lady, the month of Our Mother of Sorrows. I was reading through the Rapulta, different indulgences, etc. There are a number of them that are for the month of September. But the point is, in our reflection, in our meditation, our thoughts for Lent, let us not only consider the passion and death of our divine Lord, but let us also consider the sorrows of Our Lady. And let us not forget that we caused the one and the other. We caused the passion of our Lord, who died, as St. Paul would say, he died for me, died for each of us individually, to atone for our sins. But we also caused the tears and the sorrows of our Heavenly Mother. And that thought should lead us to amendment of life, to contrition, obviously, amendment of life, and to a more deep and tender love for our Blessed Mother, who willingly sacrificed her divine Son. She could have begged him to come off the cross, and he would have. But she knew it was necessary for our redemption. She knew it was the will of the Father. And so she willingly sacrificed her mother's rights, as the Pope said, and joined her sorrows with his. Please.